A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th March, on the front page you have no names removed based on draft NRC. So the Election Commission of India has assured the Supreme Court that names have not been removed from the Assam electoral roll on the basis of exclusion from the draft National Register of Citizens. So the draft NRC was published in July 2018. So this was to decide who are legal citizens and who are illegal citizens, foreigners who have to be extradited. So on the draft NRC, the Election Commission has said we have not changed the electoral rolls. Then below you have DGCA bars Boeing 737 MAX 8. This is the aircraft which was involved in the aircraft series which was involved in the Ethiopian airline crash. So this aircraft has immediately been grounded. All such Boeing 737 MAX 8 aircrafts have been grounded by Director General of Civil Aviation in India after the global alarm. European Aviation Regulator ESA, UK, France, Germany, Australia, Singapore have all barred the aircraft from their airspace. On page 7 you have two held for cheating Yash Raj Films costume supplier. So these are two persons accused. They hacked the supplier's email and got production house to divert fees into their own account. So such online cheating has come to the fore now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is The Power of Two. So this is regarding assembly election campaigns which will be conducted, plus also parliamentary elections are there. So the assembly election campaigns could have a bearing on parliamentary polls. So there are four states in which simultaneous elections would take place along with Lok Sabha elections. These are Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. So that is discussed here. The second editorial, Final Showdown. So this is regarding Islamic State. It is said Islamic State is facing defeat, but the search for a political solution in Syria should continue. So the Syrian problem is still not over. The Bashar al-Assad government, which is challenged by Western powers. And this is the lead article, In the Pursuit of Four Freedoms. So this talks about the principles that inform a lived life of dignity must dictate choices in the great Indian election of 2019. So this article is actually talking about how we have to uphold freedoms which we cherish. So it talks of four freedoms. So these four freedoms you can see are mentioned here. So the first freedom which is spoken of here you can see is freedom from fear. Second, it talks from freedom from want. Third is freedom against discrimination. And the fourth freedom is freedom from sexual violence. Then below the article is to serve the governed. So this is regarding Official Secrets Act. We have seen how the government threatened to invoke it against the Hindu for publishing details from documents of the government. So this article says Official Secrets Act has no place in a democracy, as the Goswami Commission had suggested in the late 1970s. So there have been many committees and commissions which have asked for Official Secrets Act to be abolished, to be have its provisions included in other acts, and eliminate the colonial or archaic provisions of this act, but no action has been taken so far. And on the op-ed page is actually an interview with a former diplomat on China, Pakistan and India relations. We'll skip it too. On page 10 you have D-Day for Azhar's UNSC listing, all eyes on China. So this is regarding how China in the past has put a technical hold on naming Masood Azhar as an international terrorist, global terrorist by UNSC 1267 sanctions committee. Now fourth attempt is being made, so it is to be seen whether China gives in to the pressure from Western powers to now, or it sticks to its earlier stand and places a hold. So this is regarding that. And below you have the continuation of the front page news, we cannot kill jobs in cracker industry. So Supreme Court has said only green crackers should be manufactured in the country from now on, but then the formula for green crackers has still not been finalized. So this is how the cracker manufacturers and the workers are being affected. So here, this is the point which is being put forth. The industry argues that the revenue generated from manufacturing and sale of fireworks is to the tune of 6,000 crores per annum. So industry supports 5 lakh families. So that is the point put forth here. On page 11, you have Supreme Court questions government on tracking assets. So Supreme Court has asked the government to confirm within 2 weeks whether its February 2018 judgment, a judgment year ago, to set up permanent mechanism to track unnatural increase in assets of electoral candidates has been complied with or not. So this is an issue which will be looked into now, which is an important issue with respect to electoral malpractices, or rather with respect to corruption in politics. On international page, you have regarding IS, Islamic State, uncertain future for Islamic State returnees. And this, so IS crumbling in its last bastion. So this is the news, and as we discussed in the editorial too. Plus here you have Xinjiang camps for jobs education. So China in its Xinjiang province, which is a region of unrest here, where Han Chinese and the Muslims as such there are in conflict, Uyghur Muslims. So here you can see that they are now China has set up a facility, an internment facility in Kushan Industrial Park, and here, it's calling them job training centers that will gradually disappear if one day society no longer needs it. So there is international criticism of these internment camps, but China calls it job facilities for jobs and education. And this is Pakistan Army eyes key role in developing giant copper and gold mines. So this is the military of Pakistan, which is swaying its leveraging its sway over the civilian government, and it's creating a role for itself in the nations in Pakistan's business affairs. On business page, you have IIP growth slows to 1.7%, retail inflation rises to 2.57%. So manufacturing growth has moderated had moderated to 1.3% in January from 2.65% in December 2019. So it's 1.7% total IIP growth, and retail inflation has risen. So the food prices are firming up. So CPI is at 2.57%. And here you have government to raise 3,500 crore via CPSE ETF sales. We should know about CPSE ETF, that is Central Public Sector Undertakings Exchange Traded Fund. So sale of these ETF, like these are fund bonds as such. So they will be sold off to come up with 3,500 crore rupees. So you should know about this. And on the last page, you have biodiversity-rich zones also hotspots of human impact. So human impacts on species occur across 84% of Earth's surface. So this is according to a study, and it says that these hotspots are also regions of high human impacts. So this is regarding the biodiversity hotspots in India too, which are Western Ghats, Himalayas in the northeast. So India ranks 16th in such human impact, with 35 species impacted on average. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.